the Blue Valley dance team got an early start on Friday football.
Thanks for checking out Fox 4 Hyvee game night.
And now the two guys that are the referees' worst nightmares, Harold and Sean.
That's right. We're bringing the pain each and every Friday, and our rain gauges overflow this evening. Harold, Shawnee Mack, dozens of football games moved away from the traditional 7 o'clock kickoff times on Fridays due to the weather.
That includes Fox 4 Hyvee game of the week, 3-1 Raypeck hosting 3-1 Park Hill.
That's their game of the week. Yep, they hosted homecoming night at Raypeck on Thursday. Both Raypeck's offense and Park Hill's defense want to be crowned kings. Tom Cruise's Panthers lead 7-6 at the break. Gunnar Griffin aims to keep it that way. This is one of six INTs thrown in this game. Josh Hood's Trojans know they're tougher than that. Into the fourth quarter, Park Hill forced to punt. The Panthers forced to watch Jalen Noel. This fake punt is faux reels. 48 yards to the house. It's a 13-10 win on the road for Park Hill.
This one was very physical. We knew that coming in. Raypeck's an outstanding team. They've got big physical kids, and they play hard. And so that's a great win for our program. And at the same time, I'm sure we're going to see those guys again.
We got Lee Summit West and Staley. This also yesterday. They've got four recent football championships, and the West scores quickly in the first quarter. On the attack, then Staley's offensive mistakes cost them. How about a little pick fumble? And let's go on the way. Andrew Cahill hit that turbo button. You would end up seeing this later on. How about a little big man touchdown? I gave you a good tease. Oh, he's rumbling. He's stumbling. Oh, he's in. 40-0, the final in that one. Okay, on the Kansas side, the biggest surprise team might be Gardner Edgerton. The Blazers, they've won 13 of their last 14 regular season games, Sean.
Fox 4's Jessica Eley is here in studio with us this week with more on GE's latest end zone endeavor. Hi, Jessica.
Hey, well, the Blazers are winning by lighting up the scoreboards. In their last four games, GE is averaging 38 points per game. Only at the East taking on Gardner Edgerton Thursday, Trailblazers. Second and goal, Tazon Crow fights his way through traffic, then falls into the end zone for the TD. Gardner Edgerton takes a 6-0 lead in the second. East looking for an answer. Austin Bergeron launches a missile to Darius Bibbs. Big first down deep into Gardner Edgerton territory. A few plays later, Morrell Fountain takes the snap and takes it in for 6. That'd be the only time the Hawks would find the end zone that night. Gardner Edgerton goes on to beat Olathe East 27-6. Winless Belton picked a tough place to seek its first win. 4-0 North Kansas City, averaging 268 rushing yards per game, mostly because of this guy. Jeremy Brown takes the handoff, rips free of a couple of tackles. Now he is doing what he does best, outrunning everyone. He takes it all the way to the crib for the score. Now we're going to move on to the next quarter. This time it's Brandon Hall showing off his speed. Hall searches for real estate and he finds it. 48 yards to the house for the touchdown. The Hornets go up 15-0. The game was eventually suspended due to weather. It'll resume tomorrow at 10 a.m. As we continue this week in review edition of Game Night, Sean has more on Rocker's road trip to Blue Valley.
Well, Jess, if you're going to pick on the Tigers, you got to do it early. Alan Terrell's ball club, they're 2-1. They're hot, averaging 21 points per game in opening quarters. But this is Rockers. They're tough, right? Second quarter, both teams want to pass the ball. Blue Valley's Jake Wolf, 93 big ones to Dorian Stevens to the house. This one's tied at 14 all at the break. Game still tied in the fourth. This proved to be the backbreaker. Wolf to throw again to Sterling Lockett. It's Blue Valley beating Rockers 21-14. The Hawklets get Miege next Friday, Harold.
That'd be interesting. Kevin Stewart's first season as Free State's head coach progressing well. Firebirds meet Shawnee Mission South, entering with a 2-0 record. And how about Vikings quarterback Weston Moore and Mike Williamson?
Catch.
Goodbye. 7-0. Let's go to the second quarter as he scoots on in. All right, Firebirds looking to even the school. Tyler Bowden, he'll break three. Little opening, little cut. That'll do you some good. Final score, Free State 44, Shawnee Mission West 28. Blue Springs South pays attention to their cheerleaders. They got a lot of them, young and old. Jacks facing city rival Blue Springs. Visiting Wildcats having their way early. Fake out the camera, guys. That was me, by the way. Quentin Fontenot, nice run. Reaches across 14-3. That wasn't the best one, though. Second quarter, Fontenot just truck sticks the defender. Get out. 51 yards, your final 35-17.
That was vicious. Mill Valley pushed Miege to the brink last Friday. This time around, Joel Appleby's Jags draw top ranked Aquinas. Pick things up in the third quarter. Mill Valley's quarterback Cooper Marsh to tie Reaches in the end zone. This thing's tied up 21 all. Dramatic effect again. Now Aquinas is up again, and Marsh looking to even the score again. This time it is picked off. Aquinas survives at Mill Valley 28-21. Let's do the eject swing. Eastern Jackson County, that is, unbeaten. Odessa playing a backyard brawl against Oak Grove. Odessa up 7-0. But to add to it, Ricardo Delgado with the pick in the end zone. He is off to the races. Gonzo with an O and a Z, you might say. They went three and out, though. Too bad. Then Josie Mirrorand skips out to Gavin Gross. He does the rest. That's a touchdown. It's 14-10 on the way to a 42-10 win.
Pembroke Hill, Lincoln Prep, let's get it. Raiders, Tigers, spotless 4-0 record, scoreless game. Here come the Tigers. Mario Woods, Jr., Weave, Bobs, shakes a couple tables. He's in there. Taking it for the 6-7-0 Lincoln Prep. Pembroke's Ennis McLinley. I hope I got that right. Sorry, Mom and Dad. Returns the favor, takes the snap, breaks a couple tackles. He's gone.
He gone.
Gone. That tied the game at 7, but your final score here, Lincoln Prep. They're up 14-7 in the lightning delay, and they go on to win 30-7.
Excelsior Springs enters Thursday night without a loss. Harrisonville enters this one without a win. However, nothing's obvious in high school football.
No, it's not.
Why we have this show.
Yeah.
Opening drive for East Springs. Brandon Glum, one of the Metro's top rushers, crunches the numbers. It's 7-0 Tigers, but for a team without a victory, Paul Menchings, Harrisonville Club, shines in this one. Jace Reynolds, another good rusher. 33 yards on this long first down. Espen Glenn, capping that drive with a scrambling touchdown. Harrisonville knocks out Excelsior Springs 21-14 on Thursday on a rainy night. We will continue our football fest right after the break when A-10 Varsity's Chad Rader, he's waiting in the wings.
There were so many upsets this weekend. Are the effects of tonight's weather to blame? You're watching Fox 4 Hyvee Game Night. And we're back, Hyvee Game Night. Sean Harrell, Chad Rader, A-10 Varsity. Let's get right to it. Upset City this weekend. What do you think about it?
A lot of big ones. Of course, St. James over Bishop Miege was the big one everyone's talking about. Rockhurst taking a tumble. Staley taking a big 40-point loss at Lee Summit West. But overall, after number one, St. Thomas Aquinas, and they got by just barely tonight as well against Mill Valley, that you can take teams 2 through 20 and kind of just throw them up in the air. Anybody can beat anybody on any given night, and that's the fun part going into the second half of the season as well as into the playoffs the rest of this year. So it's been a lot of fun so far, including this week, and we're seeing that as we get into the second half.
We're always picking Chad's brain for great knowledge. Let's give you a few minutes to talk about something you're passionate about, the A-10 Varsity Preseason Combine for basketball, Chad.
Yeah, we bring a lot of events to the metro area that a lot of kids can show their skills in front of the college coaches. This is one of them. Next Saturday, October 5th at Hyvee Arena, kids can come out. High school sophomores, juniors, seniors will be college coaches in NCAA Division II, including defending champ Northwest Missouri State. You have Washburn, many others, including NAIs and JUCOs as well. Just a one-hour session, but you get a small group of players in front of those coaches to evaluate you there just from 1 to 6 o'clock p.m. Hyvee Arena, more details at A10Varsity.com.
If you're sincere about basketball, it's a good place to be.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you can, you know, you don't have to take these road trips to different colleges and you know, take a different trip here and a visit there. They all come to you right here in Kansas City. Very affordable, $50 right there, and you get to show off everything you got with other kids around the metro as well.
Chad Rader, A10 Varsity, check out his website. Harold, play of the night.
Let's do it.
Yeah, man.
Let's go back to Blue Springs, man. My man Quentin Fontenot here. We'll slow it down for you.
Ow.
Good to see you. A little truck stick. What is that on the old PlayStation there? Is that an X or
that's a cheat code.
Yeah, something. But anyway, he gone. 49-yard touchdown. Blue Springs beats rival Blue Springs South. All right. We had a little rumble
exactly
there for a second with the rain.
Mother Nature will continue to wreak havoc as she did all week with high school football. He's Chad. He's Harold. I'm Sean. Jessica's here too. We all say good night and so long for now.
Send us your pics and video to Fox 4 Hyvee High School Game Night.